You didn't see that one coming, did you? Hello and welcome to my career on F1 2014. Now, this is the first career mode I've done on an F1 game, like, well, on YouTube anyway, because I normally do the career modes on games, but just never got around to like uploading a series on them. I think the only exception is on 2012 when I uploaded a few races, but that was just because I'd recently got a new capture card. Well, it was my first capture card and I was just uploading in any race I wanted, really. But yeah, I'm hoping that this will be like a proper series that I can do throughout, well, the next year, really. Well, at least until the next gen games come out. But yeah, we're in McLaren then. Bit unexpected, I guess, but felt doing something different. I did want to do Ferrari, but I'm already doing a few series with them, so decided to do something different with this, and here we are in first practice then. We had a bit of a slow start and it did take us a while to get up there, but we were up into 6th place eventually then on our 12th lap, and then it did take us, well, we weren't like saying consistent times anyway, and it did take us a couple of laps then to improve again as we come across the line. We're on the soft tyre at this point and we're up into P5 then, and yeah, not a bad practice session then. If you can see, Nico Hülkenberg there had a penalty. We were 6th meanwhile, and Maldonado there in the background just zooming along the grass. I don't know what he was doing there, but I guess just living up to his name. Well, not really his name, but his reputation, I guess. And Vettel was fast then. That was a bit of a surprise. We go into Q1 then. Getting into our car, this nice and shiny MP429 with no sponsorship on it whatsoever. And here we are then in Q1 at the end of the session, and we were really struggling here, and so was Jensen. And well, this was such a like a jumbled up Q1 actually, and you can see Hülkenberg was on the bobble in 16th. And well, I originally tried to do a career with Force India, but I just found the car too difficult to drive as we come across the line. And we have made it then in P10, and fastest was Kimi Räikkönen for Ferrari, so how about that? And look at that, Jensen was last. He is last on the grid. Well, it will actually be Nico Hülkenberg because he went out in that session, and of course he's got a grid penalty. So yeah, some surprises very early on in this. You can see Hamilton there only 15th for Mercedes, which a real surprise there. So yeah, a lot of surprises are going on in Q1. We're into Q2 now, and we can see it's a really poor lap start of the session actually. Making a mistake out of the final corner, and Vettel's coming up to pass this. And for some reason I just cannot set quick times at the start of sessions in this, and I think it's just because I'm getting used to the game, and I've really struggled to get up to speed with it actually, even though I do enjoy it. And you can see I improved my time there, but I was still nowhere near, and I had a lot of time to make up here after my first two runs on the final run then. And well, the time's up, so this is our last chance to make an improvement. We're coming to the line, looks like we have improved our time, but we stay 16th and only just behind Gutierrez actually. And yeah, what a disappointing qualifying that is for McLaren then. Only 16th and 22nd then. And well, we've got a lot to do in the race now then. And yeah, our driver is not going to be too happy, I don't think. Oh man, I don't know what's going on, guys. What have you done, man? What is this MP429 thing? And like 16th and 22nd, it just isn't good enough, guys. I mean, like, what are me and Jensen meant to do? Oh, we're just gonna have to go out the back and cry about it, I guess. Here is the grid then. Daniel Ricciardo on pole for his home race. We're only 16th. Our teammate Jensen Button only 21st. A lot to make up then in this, as we're on the grid now. And Webber has left our party just like he left F1. We've got the lights coming on now. And away we go then for this first race of our career. And it doesn't look like we've got the best of starts here. A lot of wheel spin. Much like Kevin Magnussen in real life there. But in turn one, we've ended up on the outside. And we're looking like we might go around a few people here. We're up into 14th place, so that's pretty good. Now we're up to 13th pass Kvyat as well. So it's been a pretty good start here. We may get a few into turn 3 as they all bunch up here, and I'm on the inside and always running to the back of Kimi Räikkönen there. Well, we are in Magnussen's McLaren, so that wouldn't be a surprise, but we're up into 12th at least. And yeah, that's not bad then. We've made it 4 places. We do run into the back of Räikkönen eventually, but doesn't look like we've done damage to either car, as Gutierrez is having a look, but he won't go through because the AI is still not fixed in this game. And Raikou's going to slow down. We've got Thrawn him. I'm going to skip now to lap 6 because I was really just holding these guys back for most of the early laps, and I really struggled to catch Massa and Perez and all that up in front. Massa pitted early though, and here comes Raikkonen, and then he made his way past Gutierrez. He was looking at us as well. We couldn't quite pull off a move on us there. And yeah, we're up into a point at least then. And it looks like some of the AI will be doing quite contrasting strategies then, as Massa in quite early. And I don't think me or anyone else is going to be in until the next lap at the earliest. But yeah, we were really struggling here. And what I've been finding is that I only can really get a few, like 2 or 3 good laps out of the tyres, and then I just really start to struggle on them, which is quite unfortunate because, well, they want to be lasting around about 8 or 9 laps, like just the option tyres here. So we make a mistake there, and it looks like Raikkonen will be right on the back of us now. And just because of how OP the AI are at that final corner, and you can see how much I'm, like, see why I struggle so much on Legend, because, well, with assists, like, they're not having the same kind of problems out the final corner. So Raikkonen was able to just drive past us in the middle of the corner. He's up into 10th place then. Gutierrez will be looking at us now as we make more mistakes out of turn 2. It looks like he might be through here, but then we ended up, he did break early in the end, and we're back up into 11th place then. And I think we are pitting on the end of this lap, so at least we're going to be getting some fresh tyres for our struggles here. And yep, in we come then at the end of the lap, and still in 11th, but then well, we're obviously going to drop a lot further back now then. In we come for another set of option tyres. I was going option prime in this one. Saw Jensen briefly fly past there, and in we come then, hoping for a good stop. And it is only 3.7, that's pretty bad actually, and I was hoping for a lot better really, because sub 3 seconds is, you know, well, just what you'd expect nowadays in real F1. But out we come then in 17th, we're behind Ericsson, which isn't very good. But of course he hasn't played yet, so we don't have to worry about that too much. And gonna skip now then to, well, when the pit stop phase was over, we found ourselves down in 12th, and Jensen's right behind us in 13th, so it's really not a good day for McLaren here. And once again I was struggling. I mean, I'd already been on these tyres about 5 laps at this point, and struggling for traction out the final corner. And now it looks like Jensen's gonna be lining us up then for 12th place. And maybe we're just going to have to leave it to him to try and salvage something from this first race of the season. We almost ran into him there in turn 1. But it looks like he's made the move very good on the outside. At least the AI are aggressive on if they stay on the racing line. But just shame that they never go for anything on the inside. We almost ran into the back of him there. We've lost our connection to the server, and we've also lost our 13th place to Nico Hülkenberg. So that was not good for us there. So we're down to 14th then. Skipping a couple more laps, and oh man, even Romain Grosjean in that awful Lotus is just driving clean past us in that final corner. Just shows how much we struggle there for traction. And well, I think not just that corner, but I think that one is the one that highlights it the most, just how much of an advantage the AI has when they've got assists and you don't. And with him we come then for our second stop, our second and final stop. And a quick note on that, well, I don't really want to drive without assists, but there's a part of me thinking that the only way I'm actually going to be able to be competitive against the AI in this game is like to either put it back down to expert or to put some assists on. And honestly, I really don't want to have to do that, because I'd never like to make things easier for myself. I always want to try and have things as challenging as possible, but at the moment it feels like I'm at a bit of an unfair disadvantage here. And I hope it is going to be sorted. I hope there are going to be some patches, because apparently if you're on a wheel then you have these problems as well, like even more. We skipped lap 26 and we were 14th after our second stop, and we're now getting lapped, which is just great. I think Hamilton had already lapped us in the pits, and Vettel's coming through then. We've held at Rosberg there, and sneaky tactics there. And well, I'm not sure what you can say really about a McLaren driver helping out the Ferrari, as Rosberg goes very slowly into turn 1 there, and we almost had a look at him there, but well, we've lost these tyres already. You can just see there on next there, turn 2. It looks like Sutil might have a look at us as well for 14th now. So, oh, that's not what we need at all. I think Gutierrez was right there as well, so It really was turning into a dismal debut race for us, but we just have to try and get to the finish, I guess. And we're going to skip to later on in the lap then. Still holding them off and into this right-hander, and just no traction on the exit, and we've lost our front wing, and that just sums up our race, doesn't it? And well, we're a lap down, so we've only got just over a lap to go. So I decided I wasn't going to bother pitting, because that would mean I definitely would drop to the back, and I figured that one lap without a front wing probably wasn't going to kill me. Well, at least drop me to the back. Well, so I thought anyway, as Kobayashi comes through. So that's pretty bad, I guess. And I don't think Bianchi's too far behind either, so we may drop behind him as well. But we won't be last, at least, as we're just struggling. And I actually thought that, what with the lack of rear grip, it might actually level out a little bit, but Bianchi's through. And we may have had a bad debut race, but not as bad as Daniel Kvyat there, down in 19th place. So I guess, well, that's a positive to take from this as we come across the line here. So rather disappointing first race of our career. Only 18th in the end, and Button only 11th as well. So no points for McLaren in the first race of the season. And oh, just to think that in real life they got a double podium. What a shame that is. But yeah, we got a couple of achievements, I think, for that first race. I'm not really sure what they were for. Hamilton wins then. Vettel was second, and Alonso third. And yeah, Button only 11th. Maldonado in the points, apparently. Well, how about that? And I think Ricciardo was one of the retirements. Massive shame for him after getting pole. And Max Chilton was the other one, so that's why I forgot about him. And the driver standings then, as you'd expect, it was, well, of course, Hamilton atop. And I'm not sure why I left that bit in there while I was opening the Xbox guide menu for no reason. But yeah, Hamilton from Vettel, Alonso, as you expect, we're down in 18th, as you'd expect. And look at that, we're nowhere after this first race in 7th. So if you've enjoyed this first race, leave a like, and I'll see you next time for Malaysia. Oh man, guys, I just don't know what to do. I mean, like, I'm not using the assist, but look at them, they've got like traction control and everything. Look, just send this guy. Look, he'll go and turn off. Yeah, you go do that.